Good morning, children. Today we will be continuing with our lesson electricity and magnetism. In the earlier video, we saw about the discovery of the magnet, and then we started with the properties of the magnet. Here in the properties, we first saw that the ends of the poles or the ends of the magnet, okay, where the force of attraction is more, are called the poles. In this, the poles are named as north and south poles, okay, and then they will be having a directional property. That is, the north pole will be pointing towards the geographical north. Geographical north means the direction in our earth, or the direction of our earth, that is called the geographical north. Okay, we know four directions, right? East, west, north and south. So if the magnet pole is pointing towards the geographical north, that is the north of the earth, then it is called the north pole. And if it is towards the geographical south, it is called the south pole. Okay, now coming to the attractive and repulsive property. Attractive property means what? Which is going to be attracted. First of all, we know magnet will attract all the magnetic materials such as iron, cobalt and nickel, is it not? So apart from that, a magnet and another magnet will also get attracted. We will see how. Okay, so we are going to take two bar magnets, okay, with markings north and south. Now if we keep the two bar magnets like this, that is the south pole and the north pole are kept together, what will happen? They will be attracted, whereas when both the south are kept, they will be repulsed. And here also, when both the poles are not, they will be repulsed. Repulsed means they will be moving away. So we are seeing this, when the south pole is close to the north pole, it will be attraction. And if it is both the poles are same, that is, if both the poles are same, that it will be called repulsion. So we can say the property as the like poles attract and unlike poles repulse. That is, like poles repel and unlike poles will attract. Okay, so now that is what the attractive property is. So the attraction between the unlike poles is called the attractive property, and the repulsion between the like poles is called the repulsive property of the magnet. So we saw each bar magnet will have two poles, one is north and one is south. When the two bar magnets are kept near to each other, if their poles are like means if both the ends are south, then they will repel. Repel means they will move away. Okay, but if they are of unlike poles, like one side is south, another side is north, they will be attracted. So the magnetic poles will always exist in pairs. However small you keep on breaking the magnet, like our Kit Kat chocolate. Okay, if you keep on breaking, there will be one end, is it not? There will be one small end arising. Likewise, every magnet, if you have, it will be having two poles. Okay, one will point towards the north, another one will point towards the south. Now we are going to talk about a magnetic field around a magnet. Okay, so what is the field? You say, what is a field in playing or in the playground? The field is the place where you can say you can play, is it not? If you hit a four, the ball should fall beyond that rope. So until the rope, you can mark it as the field to which you play. Similarly, the region around a magnet within which the magnetic substance will experience the force of attraction or repulsion is known as magnetic field. Okay, for example, if I keep a magnet in your house, Okay, you take a small magnet and you keep it at your house, and you are keeping the iron substance. Okay, iron substance in our school. Say a big crane or a big iron bar, something like that. Will it get attracted? Will it be able to attract that iron bar? No. So the field should be within the magnet's for property. That is a property of attraction or repulsion. So the region around the magnet with which the magnetic substances can be attracted or repelled is known as magnetic field. So it is represented by imaginary lines, which are called as magnetic lines of force or magnetic field lines. Okay, these magnetic field lines are curved lines. Curved line, that is like this is a curve, like our brackets. Okay, they originate from the North Pole and end at the South Pole. That is, they start at the North Pole and they end at the South Pole. The magnetic field lines will pass through a closed surface like a coil known as the magnetic flux, and the change in the magnetic field will give rise to the flux density. This and all you will be learning in your 7th and 8th. Okay, so as of now we have to know two things. That is, the region around the poles. The region around the poles where the magnet's force of attraction or repulsion is there. Okay, so until that region, it is called as magnetic field. Now, there are imaginary lines which are drawn from North Pole to the South Pole. North Pole to the South Pole. See the arrow. From the North, it is going to the South. From the North, it is going to the South. If it is only a single magnet. Now, here I am having two magnets. So, what is happening? This will be from this North to this South. Okay. Now, consider here, these are same poles, that is North and North. So, they are like poles. So, the field, the lines of imaginary lines, that is the imaginary lines, will be moving away from the poles. Okay. So, what do you understand from this? The magnetic field lines will represent the strength of the magnetic attraction. The strength. Okay. Then, the strength is not uniform throughout the length. See, the strength is not uniform. Uniform means, see, the strength is more at the what? At the poles. The strength is more at the poles. Whereas, as and when it is going outside, what happens? The strength is getting reduced. So, that is what? So, it is maximum at the poles. The strength of magnetic force is maximum at the poles and less in the middle of the magnet. Okay, so they have given one activity. What are they saying? How we are going to draw this magnetic lines of force. Okay, now after this we will be learning about the properties. The first property is the magnetic field lines are continuous. They are not breaking, they are not cut in the middle. Then they are closed curves. They are closed curves and they originate from the North Pole and converge at the South Pole. Two, three points we have seen. One is continuous, second one closed, third one is it originates from the North Pole and ends in the South Pole. Okay, then within a bar magnet, even in a single bar magnet, the field lines will move from South Pole to the North Pole. Then no two field lines will intersect each other. That is, they are almost parallel only. All the curves are parallel to each other. They will not intersect each other. Okay. Now, we are moving to the next topic. Earth as a magnet. Why we are taking Earth as a magnet? Because Earth also has direction. We saw the property, the directional property in magnet. So, we are linking that to the Earth also. Okay, Earth is having magnetic properties because it also will align in the north-south direction. That is, the Earth also is tilted, is it not? In your globe or in the atlas, you can see that the Earth is tilted along its axis and that axis is always pointing in the north south direction. So earth will act like a huge bar magnet. So the north pole is the geographic north, and the north pole is near the geographic south pole of the earth, and the south pole is towards the geographic north. So here you should be very careful. When you are considering the earth as a magnet, it will be the vice versa. Okay, that is, the earth's geographic north pole will be the magnet's south pole, if the earth is a magnet. And if it is the earth's north pole, it will be the earth's geographical south pole. You should be very careful here. Okay, and here like poles will repel again, and unlike poles will attract. So when it is suspended, the north pole is attracted by the magnetic south pole of the earth, and the south pole is attracted by the magnetic north pole. So only it is aligning itself in the north south direction. Okay, you should learn only till this much. This is enough. So earth core is what inside? It is composed of iron and nickel. So earth is having a strong magnetic field. Now coming to a compass. What is this compass? Compass is a device which is used to show the direction. Okay, it will have a magnetic needle, and the needle is pivoted. Pivoted means it will be standing on one small screw. So say, think this is a needle. Okay, if this is a needle, it will be standing like this, pivoted. Okay, so on one point only it will be fixed, so that it can be rotating, it can turn its direction. Okay, and then it will have a needle. So this is a needle is attached to this, and it will be free to rotate. Okay, so the magnetic needle will always points towards the north south direction. It will be always pointing towards the north south direction, and it is very very helpful for all the sailors, mainly in the deep sea voyages. Why? Because in the middle of the ocean or the sea, they will not understand which is the direction which they have to travel. Okay, so they will take that compass, and if they keep the compass, the needle will point to the north. Okay, and the opposite direction will obviously be always the south. Okay, and when you are standing in the north south direction, your right hand side will always be east, and your left hand side will automatically become west. So with that knowledge, the sailors will travel to the corresponding destinations. Okay, so they are taking the compass as a very very important instrument. And then this compass is having an outer case which is made up of a non-magnetic material. Why? If the non-material is magnetic, and this north-south direction is also pointing, it will be getting attracted. So they are avoiding the material outside this compass. So as they are using non-magnetic material like aluminium, brass. Okay, then see, the magnetic material, if they are made up of magnetic material, the magnetic needle will be attracted to the case, and it will not point towards the north-south direction. Okay, so in this portion, till today, I mean in this video, what were we seeing? We saw that main property, the magnetic property of attraction or repulsion. Okay, then we saw the magnetic field around the magnet. So it will be always curved line, it will be closed line, it will not intersect each other. It will start from the north pole, and it will be always ending in the south pole. Okay, and then the strength of the magnetic field is more at the poles. Okay, then we saw earth as a magnet, because in the core of the earth is having iron and nickel. So earth, and also earth also has a directional property. So together earth will act as a huge bar magnet. Okay, then we saw the new device called magnetic compass, which is mainly used by the sailors for their long voyages to indicate the direction. It will be having a needle pivoted in the center to point the north-south direction. Okay, so coming to the revision zone. Materials that get attracted to a magnet are called magnetic materials. The poles of the magnet are named north and south poles. The directional property will align the freely suspended bar magnet. The north pole of a bar magnet will always attract the south pole. Earth's magnetic north pole is near its geographic south. Because Earth, the north pole they are telling, so it should be towards the south, geographic south. So I am stopping it till here. The rest of the portion will continue in the next video. Okay, children, thank you.